us discuss the various types of hybridization involving S orbital and P orbital. The first one is SP hybridization, S and P. So, one, the process in which one S orbital and one P orbital intermix to produce two SP hybrid orbitals, SP hybrid orbitals is called SP hybridization. So, when one S and one P are combining, so there are one S and one P, so the total two orbitals are combining. So, jitne, the number of orbitals formed is equal to the number of hybrid orbitals combining. So, in SP, we have only one S. Then total number of orbitals is 2. So, the number of hybrid orbitals, the S character in each hybrid orbital is 1/2%, 1/2 S character, that is 50% S character, and 1/2, that is 50% of P character. The two SP hybrid orbitals, now apply Wesper theory to this. When two enemies are there, the shape of the molecule is linear. So, when the two SP hybrid orbitals are arranged linearly, so when they are arranged linearly like this, so this is one S orbital, this is one P orbital, when both are combining, this is the shape of hybrid orbital. So, this the two hybrid orbitals are arranged linearly and the bond angle is 180 degrees. And the different examples for SP hybridization are BeCl2, C2H2, carbon dioxide, etc. Let us see the example of beryllium chloride for SP hybridization. The central atom in beryllium chloride is Be. The ground state electronic configuration of beryllium is 1s2, 2s2, 2p0. The excited state configuration of beryllium will be, because beryllium is forming two bonds, there should be two half-filled orbitals according to the valence bond theory. So, the excited state configuration will become 2s1, 2p1. So, beryllium undergoes sp hybridization because we want two bonds. It undergoes sp hybridization to form two sp hybrid orbitals. So, the two sp hybrid orbitals of the two beryllium atoms, they overlap with the half filled p orbitals of the two chlorine atoms to form sigma sp p bonds. So, the shape of the molecule is linear and the bond angle is 180. The process in which one s orbital and two p orbitals intermix to form three sp hybrid orbitals is called sp2 hybridization. These three sp2 hybrid orbitals, there are three enemies, so they'll sit in trigonal planar manner. So the three sp2 hybrid orbitals are arranged in trigonal planar shape, and the bond angle is 120 degrees, and the various examples are BCl3, third group halides, trihydrides you can take. So, BCl3, BF3, AlCl3, BH3, C2H4, etc. are the examples. So, this is S orbital, and we have two P orbitals which are dumbbell in shape. They intermix, one S orbital and two P orbitals, total three. So, three hybrid orbitals are formed which are arranged in a trigonal planar shape with a bond angle of 120 degrees. Let us see the example of BCl3. BF3 for the sp2 hybridization. The central atom in boron trichloride is boron with a configuration of 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. There is only one half filled orbital, p orbital in boron. But boron here forms three bonds with three chlorine atoms. So, we go to excited state electronic configuration where its configuration is 1s2, 2s1, 1s2, 2s1, 2px1, 2py1, where we have three half-filled orbitals. So, the three half-filled s and 2p orbitals of boron intermix, 1s orbital and 2p orbitals of boron intermix to produce three sp2 hybrid orbitals which are arranged in trigonal planar shape with a bond angle of 120 degrees. The half-filled sp2 hybrid orbital of boron overlaps with the p orbital of the chlorine atom to form sigma sp2p bond. So, we have three sigma sp2p bonds formed with three chlorine atoms. So, this is BCl3 with a shape of trigonal planar and bond angle of 120 degrees. Let us see now sp3 hybridization, sp3. the process in which one s orbital and three p orbitals intermix to produce four sp3 hybrid orbitals is called sp3 hybridization. The so of the four sp3 hybrid orbitals will be arranged tetrahedrally. The four half-filled sp3 hybrid orbitals which are arranged tetrahedrally with a bond angle of 109 degrees 28 minutes. The various examples for sp3 hybridization are CH4, ammonia, water, C2H6, all alkanes, etc. Let us see the example of methane molecule with the help of the sp3 hybridization. We know the central atom in methane is carbon. The ground state configuration is 1s2 2s2 2p2. So we have only two half filled orbitals in carbon, but carbon here forms four bonds. So let us go to the excited state configuration of carbon, that is 1s2 2s1 2px1 2py1 and 2pz1. So the 1s orbital and 3p orbitals of carbon intermix to form 4 sp3 hybrid orbitals which are half filled. So carbon undergoes sp3 hybridization resulting in 4 sp3 hybrid orbitals which are half filled. So the half filled 4 sp3 hybrid orbitals which are arranged tetrahedrally, they overlap with the half filled s orbitals of the 4 hydrogen atoms to form 4 sigma sp3p bonds. So the shape of the molecule is tetrahedral and the bond angle is 109 degrees 28 minutes.